scripting and the basic system administration related issues. Later, we have requested an alumni who will be joining us around 11:15. He will be talking from industry perspective because he has been working on Linux for last 3 years. He works as a system engineer at Cerner Healthcare, which is a first probably company for you that you'll be recruiting from placement point of view. You'll be getting insights from placement perspective as well as how Unix or Linux is being used at the industry level. So I want all of you to actively interact with Mr. Vasuki and get inputs in this regard. So over to Sudarshanam, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, students. Actually, right person you have chosen, sir. So to tell it, because the placement questions through AWQ only, he has entered into the software company. So even students also can ask that one.
That's why I want them to utilize that.
Correct, correct. Students, yes, they have to utilize now.
Yes,
so
yes.
Only they, he has done, he has not chosen DBMS concept. He has chosen AWK. Within 5 minutes, he has completed. He came out, he got the job. Before night, I don't know, somehow he got the some questions like that question. Sir, if you get it like this, how to do it? So we have given some clue. He has done it and he has entered it to the software company. Thank you. Anyway, you are getting good person, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, shall I start, sir?
Yes, sir, please go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Today we'll discuss about AWK programming and bit system administration or some of the server, one server configuration, I'll tell you. So how it will work, that server, DNS server. So before starting, shall I know, do you have any doubts yesterday class, grep options? Did you practice the commands? Amit, Manish?
No, sir, no doubt.
Do you have any doubt?
No, sir.
Yesterday class, yesterday grep options set, and in that set also two things we have done it. One is called Linux, sorry, line addressing, and another one is called the context addressing.
No, sir.
Any
no
doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Shall we move to now AWK programming?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We'll move to AWK programming. So, AWK, ARC programming is nothing but advanced filters. So, we have done some of the filters. See, you have many options. So, since 5 days, you are seeing basic commands, you have learned it. There, how to merge it, you have seen. Next is some of the filter commands and regular expressions, how to solve it. And grep command we have seen, set command also we have seen. Now we are going for the AWK. So the finally, when they are asking some of the questions, they will not say which concepts you have to utilize it. So you as a programmer, you have option to choose anyone. Only thing is, whenever you are choosing, you have to choose the right one to solve that particular problems. So finally, what you have to do? You have to read the questions properly, which is suitable for that, which is suitable to solve that one, that you have to take it and you have to solve it. Now, ARC programming is nothing but is a programming. This is also called pattern matching and processing tool available in Unix. So here is the syntax. ARC programming filtering syntax is nothing but AWK options, selection criteria, action, what action to be done, and files. So here is grep command. What we have done is grep command. What we have done, there also selection criteria, we have done it. Now AWK programming, what else extra things we have done here? What extra we are doing here, we have to check it out now. AWK option, selection criteria, action, and files. So here is some of the fields. You can cut it and paste it like file only. So apart from there, what we have done is we have searched some of the names. For example, etc password, whether our username is there available or not. Like system related programs, we have done it. Now here is, for example, if I'm having one file, in that if you are having some of the repeated names. So I want to delete and repeated names. If it is repeating more than one times or more than 5 times or 10 times, I want to delete that and I want to display it. So you can go for these options. Apart from that, you can use the arrays concept here and you can store it into that one and you can display it. For example, MCA department students, I want to count it. First year, how many are there? Second, how many are there? Third, how many are there? In grub command, what we have done is only you have selected the particular file and particular informations you have dragged it. But now AWK programming, even you can do some of the calculations also. So you can retrieve the data, and using the data, you can perform, you can process some of the calculations in that. That is what the difference between grub command and AWK command. AWK. So ACK programming is nothing but what you can use here arrays also. You can perform particular task. For example, I told you I want to count it. All the students, how many people are there in BMSIT with respect to branches? For example, CSE, if you take first year, how many are there? Second year, how many are there? Third year, how many are there? Fourth year, how many are there? Total students, I want to count it. Like that, I want to count it entire college. See, in our, for example, if you take our exam in our website, it is available some of the informations like MCA students, like BE students, but different branches students. I want to take that information, so I want to count it. So AWK is suitable to solve that particular problems. Now that is what the AWK advantages. Now we'll see how it will be working yesterday, how we have done parallelly the command, how it will be working here also. And we'll see syntax and we'll type it and we'll check it out whether it will work or not. Now AWK syntax is nothing but what I told you, AWK option selection criteria. You can select the criteria action so that what type of action you want to perform it for the particular files. That is what the syntax is. Yesterday what we have done is grep option. So you have done it, you have selected criteria and particular files. You didn't have option called action. So you can do action is nothing but what you can perform some of the tasks here. For example, I told you, you want to count number of the students for the particular branch or total, like that you can calculate it. The same example I will solve and I will show you at end of the class. Now this is what the AWK way of working. Now we'll see how it will be working the next one. Example, AWK manager print emp.list. So AWK manager print emp.list. So for example, if you type like this, how it will be working. So now yesterday we have typed already some of the file names. In that, how it will be working, we'll see it now. Example, cat the command. So cat emp dot list. So now this is what you are having the file name. Yesterday whatever we have taken, the similar way we will take it. So here I have typed it with different example, but here because already we have file name emp.list, the same file name will take it here also. Now I want to print it. So here manager have printed. Now I want to print it the qualification who are all having MCA. I want to print it now. So now just type it AWK. So what a pattern you want to search it, single quotes or double quotes. Yesterday what we have done it, the same way we have to do it here also, slash. So MCA slash. Now you have to what perform you want to do it. I want to print it. See the syntax, print entire thing. I want to print it wherever you are having print. So close the bracket and file name is called emp.lst. See now how it will be working. So now wherever you are having MCA, only that is called printed. So that is not the pattern AWK. So here, like this is nothing but like yesterday, whatever we have done it called grep command only. But here is when we are practicing, we'll go for the basic commands, then we'll go for the advanced. I'll tell you, I'll take one file, how to take that information, how to process that information, how to display it. I'll tell you with syntax, with programming at the end of the class. Now we'll see one command individually, how it will be working. Finally, we are clubbing and we are executing. So now this is what the way of working the AWK. Now I want to execute one more command like AWK. AWK. So I want to print it like BMS IT faculty members. So colon slash BMS IT slash print it, open bracket, print, and close the bracket, end with the single quote, and file name is called emp.lst. So see, now for all belongs to BMSIT faculty members, I want to display it. I've displayed it here. Now the similarly, you have emp1 also, so you can take that and you can print it. See, there for all belongs to BMSIT, it is displaying some of the with number, so 2040 some number, name, department, qualification, and the college name. So that is what the AWK syntax, simple syntax way of working. AWK manager print emp.list. Now let us go for the next one. So see here, since printing is the default action of AWK, any one of the following. See now, any three commands. You have the three commands here. These three commands so you can use it which way you want. So I'll show you all the three commands, the way of working here also. See, clear. Now the first one is called print of the second one. So second one, it is executed. So I'll take the first file only because you can see more examples. So emp.list. The same one. So if you are deleting printf, what will happen? See here. See the same answer. Now another one is called, you have that one, you can use it, print and the dollar. Open bracket, print and dollar zero. Close the bracket. So here is, this is you can see how it will be working. Now this is also same thing. So since you have the printing default action AWK, three ways can be done, which way you want you can do it. So AWK, search the pattern which one you want to print it. So here is the action is nothing but which type of action I want to do it. Even you can do some of the calculations, or you can print it only some of the rows also. So that we'll see it how it will be working now. Now next one is AWK use the regular expression in said style for pattern matching. So you can use it pattern matching how you are doing. So example AWK minus F, so pipeline symbol, so start with R, start with R. So you can have the options called A comma zero in between and star. So you have the zero or more than one options from the emp.list. So what will happen here is R is started. Now you have A comma zero. So A comma O. So you have the zero options, or you have A comma zero also continuously. So here is A comma zero. It is not there. So R is starting. It is displayed. Now here is A is there, but O is not there. So that's what the zero or more than one occurrences, the way of working is nothing but the emp.list. So this is what the AWK F pipeline symbol, and check the conditions with what type of set command, the which way you are using, the similar way you can use it, AWK command. Now we'll go for the options. Example, so you have AWK minus F pipeline symbol and production printf. I want to print it only the second column, third column and fourth column. So zero is nothing but what happened. So in this case, you have printed zero. So zero means it will print entire thing. So now if you are entering first, second, third, $1, $2, $3, $4, what will happen? You want to check it out. You need to check it out. So see here, what they have done is example AWK minus F field, cut the field. F is nothing but the field. So cut it, and pipeline is nothing but cut that one. So production, and which one you want to print it? I want to print it the second one, third one and fourth column only from the EMP dot list. Now the similar example, we'll type it and we'll check it out here how it will be working now. So for example, AWK minus F. So you have the pipeline symbol because the previous example and this example is combinedly I'm typing and I'm showing. So pipeline symbol and close the double quotes and search the pattern, which one you want to do it. Slash, now pattern is nothing but I want to print it like the same example. I will take BMSIT wherever it is available. I want to print it. Slash, close the slash and give the what you want to print it. So I want to print now. Just I will print it second and third one. So what will happen? $2, $3. See, now I'm printing only $2, $3. So close the bracket and end with the single code and EMP dot list. See, now that is what the syntax here. So what happened? AWK, we have typed. Option is nothing but minus F. Field, which one you want to cut it, which one you want to search it. That is nothing but the BMSIT, wherever it is available in that particular file. So print, and I want to print it only the second one and third one from the EMP dot list. Now let us see how it will be working this, and we'll check it out. What is the output you will be getting? Not open $2, $3. So enter this. Yesterday night I checked it out. AWK minus F, correct only.
Sir, I think after curly braces you have given space here, sir.
Where?
After curly braces, then space, then you have written print.
Here?
Yes, sir.
That is okay, no problem. Even if you give space also okay, if you are not giving space also okay.
Okay.
See here, previous command, BMSIT slash AWK BMSIT, you have worked it and print within the quotes only we have given it. So no problem that one. Type it once again. Yesterday, we'll check it out that command. I have typed it yesterday. Morning only I have checked it. It is showing empty. We'll only print it, we'll see. Print is working. Print is working. Now we'll go for $0. We'll check it out whether it will work or not. $0 also is working. So now we'll go for the $1 also, okay, $2. $3, $4. Okay, cat emp will go to file dot lst. I'll go for the prog 1.txt. Yes, I only thing is gedit emp dot lst. So here is, we might have given, we have to give only one space, I hope. So then it will work. I'll check it out this.
Sir, I think we have to give column name, sir. Column name also.
Ah, correct. So just I'll check it out this. So sometimes space also the problem. So now we'll see that whether it will work or not. EMP dot tx lst. Okay, so programming we'll check it out. Program it is working, so I'll show you end of that one. Maybe command mode it is not working. So in programming it is working, no problem. We'll show, I'll show you that one. So next one is, here is one more command is awk minus f and 2 to 4. So that means I want to print it the second line to fourth line. So printf nr, so nr is nothing but $2, that is nothing but the two second column, third column and fourth column. So here is from second to fourth I want to print it. That means nr is nothing but second line to fourth line I want to print it from the emp dot list. So that one we'll check it out now at least. So here is, have typed it awk minus f colon nr is equal to 2 to n is equal to 4. So from the emp dot list. So $1, $2. So here is, is a problem. Okay, sometimes it will work, sometimes it's showing the problem. Okay, so I'll show you in the program only, no problem. So here is the way of explanation is nothing but, so from two, if you are giving 2 to 4 means from second line to fourth line it should work. So that is what the way of working the emp dot list. So nr is nothing but illustrate the following example. So here is, we can specify the number of lines we want to use the built-in variables. So that is called the second one. Next one, sorry, is nothing but, sorry, and you are having the example here also, awk minus f, awk minus f pipeline symbol, and start with either small letter or capital letter, and u, and the question mark of ar, that is nothing but what, always the end with the AR. I want to print it only the name with AR. So that means first to start with K and end with AR. So sometimes, for example, if you take other, sometimes we are entering the informations, finally we'll get wrong names only. So in that case, they can check it out. So whenever they want to search the particular name, so start with particular character and end with the particular character. In between, what are all the names it is available, you want to display it. So you can display it. So here is like 3D is nothing but the space. Here is nothing but the minus 20S is nothing but space. So you can print it, how much memory you want to allocate it and display it. So the 3D is nothing but left to the right, it will print it. Minus 20S is nothing but what? It will be printing 20 memory spaces and it will be printing the right to left. So that is what the space. Now NR is nothing but the variable name and here I want to print it $2, $3. So that is what the way of spin is this one. So NR is nothing but the first one and second one is nothing but the second field. This is nothing but the third field. So this is what the way of working. Next one is example. Here even you can go for sort also. Sort is nothing but whatever the information previous you are declaring here. So the first field it will be sorting and it will be printing. So you can use the sort command and it will be printed that one. Now examples like variable names in AWK, you can take x is equal to 4, x is equal to 3. If you are trying to print x is equal to 4, x is equal to, if you are printing, the fourth one will be displayed. Next one is print x. That means what? I have used here same variable, here also same variable. First, if your command line, if you are typing expressions, first one will be printed first one, second one will be printed second one. Next one is example z is equal to hello. That is nothing but the output hello. So example 2, y is equal to tab t hello 7. So now you are trying, if you are trying to print y, what will happen? Print two tabs followed by the string hello and sounds the beef. So that is what the way of working. This is nothing but so like C++, you have done it. So this you can practice it later. So next one is nothing but z is equal to hello world. Print z is nothing but it will print it hello world. The same way here also. Example 2, anyway, this print commands, anyway, I'm telling in the programming. So in this, anyway, we'll see it in the program. So how it with this commands anyway, whatever you are using the print statement, we are using in the program directly, we'll see in the program only. Suppose if you are declaring one variable name is equal to Unix and one is nothing but AWK, if you are trying to print P comma Q, so print Unix and AWK. If it is a string, it will print it like that only. So if it is example 3, X is equal to Unix and Y is equal to Linux, if you are doing, so print is equal to X and Y. So print Unix and Linux. So this is what the way of printing the in AWK. Now you have the comparison operations in AWK. Here also it is available. AWK is also provide the comparison operators like less than, greater than, less than or equal to, not equal to, etc. So now this is also, we'll see it now. Now example $AWK minus F, that is nothing but the pipeline, $3 is equal to manager. That means what? First one, $1, $2, $3 is nothing but the third column wherever you have the manager and R, S is equal to chairman. So that is nothing but chairman. So manager and chairman, wherever it is available from the third column, I want to display it. So you can display the emp.list. See, so that is the way of searching. So in grep command, what we have done is grep minus option and searching the pattern, that's it. But we didn't have any option to choose like this. So here you can choose in the same field, I want to search two names and that one I want to print it. Even though you can do some of the operations also, calculations also, you can perform particular task here. So that's what this one. Next one is nothing but you have the output. For example, if you write it manager and chairman, so see here, wherever you have the manager and chairman that feels I want to print this example, this one. So this is nothing but the $3 is equal to manager and chairman. Wherever you are having that values to be printed. See here, chairman, manager, manager, manager. So this is the way of printing the conditional checking. And also I want to print it overall drawing more than 15,000. You can calculate it. Or suppose if you are taking employee database and if you want to calculate the salary for the employees for the particular company, you can calculate it and you can execute the program. Next one is, here is see example. Here is just searched with chairman and manager. Now here example we'll see here. So you have taken less than greater than symbols also. Now AWK minus F, $3 is not equal to manager. So other than the manager, I want to search it here, and $3 is not equal to chairman. So who are all managers, chairmen, because their salaries may be more. So that I want to avoid it, and different calculations may be, it will be there. So you can choose that and calculate it and you can do it. But here anyway, we are not doing any operations. And so that should be greater than printf. So you want to print it the names and the designation and their salaries, $2, $3, $4. That is what the way of printing now. Now we'll see the next one here. See, next one is nothing but what? That's what the same one comparisons only. So AWK minus F, $5 is greater than or equal to 7,500. So printf 20s, that is nothing but the space, 20 memory spaces you are calculating. You want to print it in that 20 memory allocations. That is what the first name is called Ganesh. Next one is called the J. Sharma. Another one is called the Rohit. Another one is called the Rakesh. The second next field is nothing but third field is nothing but the designations. And fourth field is called the overall drawing salary more than 7,500. I want to display it. It is displaying here. Now, so this commands, the problem is when you are writing in the programming, it is working. When you are trying to type it in the command mode, it is not working. We'll directly will write it in the program only. That is the reason I'm not showing here. So because this pipe, it is showing the error. So directly entire thing, it is working. So wherever you are taking the cutting the fields, that is not working here. So in programming, it is working. So I'll show you directly in the program only. You write these conditions in the programming and how to execute, I will tell you. End of this explanation. Next one is example AWK. Here is what the condition is nothing but what? I want to print it the informations like here we have printed names, designation, their salaries, some of the data, some of the dates are available. Probably we'll take the date of birth now. So the condition is here is $5. That means what? $1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth column. Whatever the drawing, overall drawing more than 7,500, that is called the 7,500 is nothing but this one. Overall drawing 7,500, I want to print it. Next is $6, overall born 1980. So 1980, here is nothing but the tilde symbol. This is nothing but the dollar. So here is nothing but the last column, overall born in the 1980 and less than that. So I want to print it here. So now printf minus 20s, and the fields are second one, third one, fourth one, and sixth one, emp dot list. So 80 and less than that, I want to print it. So 80 80 80. See, now another condition is nothing but here, that's what I told you. Some of the calculations also you can do it. Number processing. So number processing is nothing but what? Numeric computations can be performed in AWK. So you can perform the some of the tasks here using the arithmetical operations also. So yesterday, whatever we have done is nothing but just we have extracted the information either using set command or grep command. Now what we have done is you have extracted the informations plus you are doing some of the operations. So that means what? You are doing some of the processing. How to do the processing here is nothing but let us do some of the calculations here. So $5, so whatever it is there here, and for that 40%. For example, any organization, they'll fix some of the salary for the basic, some of the salary. For that, they'll be giving based on the cities. For example, HRA, you who are all staying, either government employees or private employees, whoever it may be. So metropolitan cities, always the HRA will be high because rent they have to pay more. So here is metropolitan cities 30%. If it is the same person, same government employee, if they're working in villages, for them there may be 10% or 5% will be their HRA. So like that, some of the calculations, if you want to perform, so you can perform it. So here is the basic for that 40%. I want to calculate it, I want to display it here. That's what the processing, that's what I told you. So do the some of the processing like calculations, how to do the calculations. So let us see here, who are all getting the AWK minus F, and $3 is equal to manager. So in that particular file name, this field, who are all the managers are there, I want to print it. So when you are printing $1, $2, $3, you are printing. So that is nothing but the second column, third column, fifth column you have printed. Now, the next column, fifth column, whatever you are printing, apart from that, I want to calculate their HRA or DA, something like that. So example, you can take anyone. So $5 into 50%. So this into 40%, whatever it is coming, 9 into 4, 36. So 875 into 40%. That means 0.4 is nothing but 4 into 4 divided by 100. Or directly you can enter 0.4, no problem. So that is called the emp.list. So this is what the AWK examples. So now you see here, if you are taking the example program, for example, in the database employment EMP list is available. In that, I want DBMS, if you take the same example. So I'm not degrading any DBMS here. So just example I'm telling you. So if you want to some of the perform the task there also, you have to create the table, you have to insert it, and you have to, when you're taking the informations, like this calculations, bit difficult. So here is just commands, the same syntax as anyway you're accessing and you're printing, just one command you're writing 0.5 into 4 from the emp.list. So it will drag it and it will display. And you can store it into the file. Storing into the file already, first basics they might have told is greater than symbol, and you can give one more file. You can store the informations also in that. So that is what the number processing. Next one is called here syntax. So these are all the options. AWK is nothing but what now? Awk programming is nothing but what? Here, searching the informations, and you can perform particular tasks. That means what? You can do processing some of the informations here. So that means what? Suppose if you're having any calculations, you can do it. That calculations is nothing but the less than, greater than, arithmetical operators, or whatever you operators you want, we can use it, and you can perform particular task. That is what the AWK advantages. Now the syntax, how to write the programming. So these commands and these commands, all commands, command line is not working because grub command I told have shown each and every command in command line mode, but this AWK command prompt, it is not working. We have to write it in the program only. So whatever I have told till now, that one directly we will write it in the file and then we'll execute it. That is what today we'll be doing, because each and every command, like yesterday, I cannot show it today because it is not supporting that shell. Next one is, here is, you have the syntaxes. Awk syntax is available, so the begin and end sections are optional and take the form. So begin is there, action, end action is there. So now you have the begin and you have the action. So what type of action you can do it? So end and action. So AWK statements are usually apply to all the selected lines by the address. So just you can write it one line statement what type of action to be done. So here is in your file name awk, what will happen? Like C++, you have to try to open the file, then you have to read the informations, you have to process it. But awk, what will happen once you write particular task? So automatically it will be doing all the lines till end of the file. So no need to write here any conditions to execute the program. So just you write it, perform what you want to perform, what you want to processing the data, what type of action you want to write it. You write it here, automatically system will be taking care and to get the output. So that is what the meaning here. AWK statements are usually applied to all lines selected by the address. And if there is no address, then they are applied to every line of input. So every line of the input will be displayed as it is. That's it. If you have to print something before processing the first line, you can print it. So that is what the examples here, the syntax. You have the begin, open bracket, close bracket, what type of action, end, what type of action. This is nothing but the initialization processing, what we want to do it. Action is nothing but end action is nothing but normally we'll write what type of printing you want to do it here. So here, for example, action, why they have written is, for example, if you take arrays, I want to move from one to n, one to last, because you're stored into the array, you have taken the data informations from the file, and you have done some processing and you are storing into the arrays. So that is called the beginning action. End action is nothing but, so you, once you store into the arrays, so arrays you want to print it means you have to use the looping statement, first array, second array, third array. That is the reason here also we have written the action here. So normally what we'll do here, just we'll write it processing the informations when we are taking the data from the file. So here is, when you want to print it, we'll print it. Normally that way we'll split into that one. I'll show you the example how it will be working that one. Now arrays also can be taken here, awk programming. So awk also will be supporting, awk also will be supporting the arrays. Now here is array is also, array already you know that collection of the homogeneous data types. So here, so one field, one thing will be taken here. So like normally here maximum, if you are not using any calculations, like strings only will be considered here. So an array is also a variable, except that variable can store a set of values or elements. So here are not formally defined, an array is considered declared the moment it is used. So here is array, normally it is not declared properly here. So based on the calculations, based on the informations, array will be utilizing here. Now array elements are initialized to zero or an empty string unless. So it array elements are initialized to zero or empty strings unless initialized is explicitly. So that is what the way of initialization. Next one is arrays expand automatically. So array automatically will be expand here. So suppose some of the file will be having 5 lines, some of the file will be having 20 lines, some of the file will be having n lines. So arrays will be automatically, so like that is called the dynamic memory allocations will be taken care here. So the index can be virtually anything, it is even be string. So that is what the way of working here. Now let us see the example here how it will be working. Now write an awk script to delete the duplicate lines from the text file in order to the order of the original lines must be remain unchanged. So here is, now what I have done is I have to write awk script. When you are writing the scripts, when you have the duplicate names or duplicate text in the particular line, that should be deleted. Now before explaining this, I'll come to the next example program. Now I'll commit here. Now output is nothing but I have created one file is called the text file. So when you created the text file, I have taken here Ajit, Anil, Lakshmi. Once again, I have typed it called Ajit. So next one is called Anil. Next one is called PRINK. So these are all the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 names I have taken, but twice it is got repeated here. That is called the Ajit and Anil. So if you remove duplicate, what is the program says? You have to read the text file and delete the duplicate lines, and it should be displayed here. Here. Now what I have done here, Ajit is first time it will be displaying. Anil, you have to check it out the previous array whether Anil is available or not. If it is not available, you print it here. Lakshmi, you have to check it out this and print it. Now Ajit. So when you are Ajit, you are taking, when you are checking the arrays, so Ajit is available, you have to eliminate that one. That means no need to print it here. Now Anil to be taken and check it out here in the previous array. So Anil is available, so that to be deleted here. Next is Priyanka. So Priyanka, so that is not available in the text file, that should be printed. Now question is nothing but what? You have to read one text file. You have to read one text file, and in that duplicate names to be deleted and printed to the other file. So that is what the output. So you have to print the output is called the this one. Delete the duplicate files and print it the remaining names. So that is what the question says. Now write an IWK script. Delete the duplicate lines. Delete the duplicate lines from the text file. So you what you have to do is you have to create one file. You have to enter some of the names. So in that when you are printing the output, what you have to do is delete the duplicate lines. So if it is repeating the name, that to be deleted. That is what they happening. Now syntax already I told you. So question, is it clear now? Question is clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now, tell me, sir.
One thing, sir. So that search will be case sensitive or not, sir?
Yeah, case sensitive here also.
Okay, sir.
Unix like, always case sensitive.
Like Anil in capital is say is
yes.
Anil
yes.
In small letter.
So data processing yesterday also we have done it. No, capital letter, small letter, that is there. Okay. Case sensitive one. So okay. That also I will type it and we'll see that one. One example okay. We'll take care that also. So okay. Now output is what your doubt is. Here is Anil is there here. Same thing only I have done it. Now in the text file I'll type it here also small letter Anil. We'll see that one also. I'll show you this example, execute and I'll show you.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So okay, now sir. Question is clear now.
Yes, sir.
So that's what I told you in class also. I'll tell you the same thing. First read the question once, twice. You identify what is the input values, what output you have to get it. So once you do that, then programming is simple. So maybe you are writing in Java or AWK or C, C++, whatever it may be, or .NET, whatever it may be. So that syntaxes you should know, that's it. The syntax is easy. So only thing is, any one programming language, if you are perfect, up to the looping statements, then the remaining thing is very easy. So that's what the basics always is important. So now here is question is nothing but what? You need to take one text file. You have to type it some of the names in that, and when you are displaying, when you are reading and displaying, delete the duplicate lines and display it. That is what you need to do it here. So now begin. So here is already I told you, begin the statement and action. Now end action. Syntax is clear now. So syntax is, I'll show you once again here. Syntax is begin action, end action. Correct now? Begin action and end action. Now here is begin is there, end is there. Here some action, here some action. Now you can ask me one doubt here, sir. Why you have given begin, open bracket, close bracket? Again, you have done it some of the operations. Correct, no? Correct, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That is what I am also having the same doubt now. Why I have written the code here, open bracket, close bracket. Again, open bracket, close bracket. So normally C programming, when we are writing, we'll say, teachers will say, no, you cannot open whenever you want without the condition or without the looping statement. But here we have not written any looping statement. We have not written any condition, but just simply we have opened and we have closed it. Why? So that is what now. Now I'll tell you the reason. The actually begin, open bracket, close bracket. You remember the syntax is nothing but in ACK programming, begin, action. end action. That means one open bracket, one close bracket. Begin also one open bracket, close bracket. Again, based on the syntaxes, based on the questions, you have to do it. Now let us come to the output here. Now here is, okay. I have not copied it here, just I'll copy it here. So program starts. Here is, now how many times you want to print it here? Program start? Only one time, correct? Now I want to print it only one time. So that is the reason here, it will be printing one time. Suppose if you're removing close bracket and open bracket, if you are putting into the only one action begin to end, what will happen? Every time it will print program start, next conditions, now program start conditions. Here you have not given any conditions, that's one. So program starts, it will print only one time. I'll show you the example. I have typed this program and I'll execute and I'll show it to you here. Now actions. So here is data dollar of two plus plus is equal to zero. So line plus plus count plus plus is equal to dollar of zero. So now what is the meaning for this? So now data of dollar of zero plus plus is equal to zero. Is equal to zero. This is equal to zero is nothing but what? End. Till you get end of the file, you need to read it. So here is normally it will take, because we have not used any looping statement here. So why we are not using looping statement is nothing but what? AWK, right? Once it is starting from the file till end, it will be doing the process automatically, no problem. So no need to use any looping statement here. So when you are doing the action in beginning part, so once it is started the file till end, it will be moving automatically. Looping statement is not required at all. But if it is C programming, means you have to write it till end of the file. Till end of the file. Good morning, Vasuke.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
I'm doing good, sir. How are you, sir?
Yeah, fine. Where are you now?
Home. I'm at home.
Now you are at home only, or out of India?
Home, sir. Now I can't go out of India.
Okay, you are in Yelahanka only?
Yes, sir, in Yelahanka.
Okay. So up to same. That's what I was telling. Morning only.
Sir.
So he loves AWK programming. That's what I told to Ganesh sir also. You are bringing a right person. So you tell which way is helpful when they are preparing for placements.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So anyway, let me complete this. 11 o'clock, no, for your schedule?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So another 10-15 minutes, I'll finish this one and then I will come.
Okay.
Okay, sir. So here is data of dollar of zero. So that is nothing plus plus of zero. So that means incrementing that one till you get the end one. So now here is line plus plus count and dollar of zero. Dollar of zero means if it is repeating that one, it will be permitting automatically. So that is what the condition here. Now that if condition still end of the file, it will be reading and it will be stored into the line of the array. So now repeated lines, it will be deleted automatically. Here it will be omitting now. So now end action is nothing but processing. Now because all the informations, non-repeated names, it is stored here. Now you want to display it here. For I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to count, I plus plus. Printf line of I. So that means what? Array you have to move from 1 to 1. But in AWK, what happened? No need to write the looping statements. Once it is starting, till end of that informations, automatically data will be moved it here. Now the same program will execute it and will see the how it will be working. Right. So here is, how typed it, star ls star dot awk. So now program one dot awk already have typed it. So now just go for that one, gedit awk. PROG 1.awk. Right. Begin. Printf. Program starts. Close the bracket and open the bracket. Data of $0 plus. Already I told you how it will works. $0. So entire program will be taken. So plus plus 0 is equal to 0, line plus plus count is equal to 0. So whatever I have shown the example there, same thing code. So I have stored it here. Just save, come out of the program. Now, next. So you have to give one file name. Now you have to give text file. So to this command line argument. Now how to give it, that one you see, we'll see it here now. Now gedit so here is how given Anil, SUDA, Ganesh, Dwaraka, Charanu, Madhu, Dwaraka, this one. Now somebody told Manish, no? So sir, if I give it Anil, what happened? And one more is ANIL and ANIL, correct, no? So Anil is three times is repeated. One is capital letter also I have taken. So now this is what, how it will be working. You have to see it now. Now let us see how it will be working, that one. So save this one. Now what is your program? You have to read the names, delete the duplicate names. Now cat program1.txt. So program1.txt, it is printed some of the names. Now which name is deleting twice, that name should be deleted. Now you have to run the program. So the way of running is nothing but awk minus f prog1, a file name, and you have to pass the text. So now see the output, what happened now. So see here, your text is nothing but what here, Anil, SUDA. So Anil is printed first time, SUDA is printed second time, Ganesh is printed next time, Dwaraka is printed as it is, next Charan is printed, next Madhu is printed, next is what, capital letter Anil, but here small letters, case sensitive. Manish, now is it clear now? You ask some question, no?
Yes sir.
It's case sensitive because same name, but here capital letters, only one character is capital letter, here all letters are capital letters only. Okay, now yes, second one is called ANIL. So this is repeated now. So that is not printing. Next, last Anil also, it is repeating, that is not printing here. This is not the way of displaying the deleting the, read the file name and delete the repeated names. That is not the way of working the AWK. And you can calculate employee salaries and you can process the data. So grep command, set command is nothing but what, that is also searching the pattern only, but there we cannot do any operations there, for you cannot perform any tasks there. But here what happened, you can perform particular task here also. That means what, you can process the data also. You can process the data. If it is the grep command, if you take it the same one, what will happen? Entire informations will display it. That's it. Ignore case, if you take it, Anil, it will be printed four times. But there we cannot delete it. But here you can process the data. So that is what the difference between grep command, set command, searching pattern, here also searching pattern. There also searching pattern, here also searching pattern. But here the way of thing is different. But set command, there you can delete some of the rows there, but you cannot perform particular task here. So there, that is what the difference between that one and here. So now this is what the way of execution. So that's what I told you, know, program starts. Suppose if the same program, if I do it the different way, what will happen? Say, see it here. Gedit program.awk. Suppose if I'm not giving this, what will happen? Check it out. So begin open bracket, close bracket. So I have not given any close bracket in this case. So now see here what will happen. Program starts, programs end. So it is not displayed anything here now. That is what the difference is. That is the reason we have given it. So now again, we'll go to program. We'll change that modification once again. So that is where the program starts and program end. So here I have not given any slash n. That is the reason it is the same line it is displaying. So that is what the way of working the AWK. So now, so some of the system administration roles and responsibilities, just I'll tell you only few lines. So system administration roles and responsibilities is nothing but install and configure software and hardware. So normally that one only. Manage the network, several servers and technologies tools. So even you can manage the network servers and technologies. Actually, I thought of showing this one demo, how to install one or two packages. Because of the time less, I'm not able to do it. So set up accounts and workstations. Second, yesterday I shown you how to create the users and workstations. Workstation, I've not shown demo, but how to create, I've told you username, how to create it. Another one is called monitor performance and maintain system accordingly, according to requirements. Next is troubleshoot the issues and outages. Next is ensure the security through access controls, backups, and firewalls. So system administrator maximum, they have to take care backups only. Suppose if you go for real-time applications, banking and all, what will happen? Every minute, every second, not minute, every second, they have to take up the backups. Otherwise, what will happen? Some of the cases we are seeing, we are trying, when we are trying transferring some of the amount, sometimes it will struck it. So in that case, they have to track it, everything. So that is the reason when they're tracking, it will take for us 2 to 3 days to rectify that errors. So they have to take up the backup, what is happening, whether that transaction is happened properly or not, they will check it out. Then they will go ahead according to that one. That is what this one. Normally system administrator main roles is nothing but creating the users or deleting the users or installing the softwares and maintaining the networking servers. So that is what the major things. Next is, develop the expertise to train staff on new technologies and build an internal wiki with the technologies documentation, manuals, and the IT policies. They have to maintain the IT policies, all those things. Now, this is what they have given. Write an AWK script, compute the gross salary of the employees according to that one. So what you have to do is, you have to take 5 to 6 rows. One is called, for example, a serial number, employee name, department, and their basic salaries. Now, basic salary, you take 1 or 2 examples less than 10,000, 1 or 2 greater than 10,000. So if it is less than 10,000, their HRE is 15% and DA is 45%. And salary is less greater than 10,000, for them HRE is 20%, DA is 50%. You have to calculate it and you have to print it. That is what the one assignment. So you do it only one. So that is more than sufficient. So for this one more, I'll show you how to do it also. Here somewhere I have shown you that. Here. See here, the calculation, I have shown you the examples also. I want to print it $2, $3, $5. So here you can write it 1, 2, 3, 4 directly. It will print all. Whatever you are taking, it will print it. And HREI is nothing but 40% means here example I told you one is called 45% and HRA is called 15%. 15 is nothing but 10,000 into 15 divided by 100, otherwise 10,000 into 15 you can write it plus this one and you can print it that one. So the similar way here how I have shown the example, you have to write it in your program also the same way. That is what you have to do it. This is what your assignment. Can you able to do it now? If you have doubt, you can ask me later. So this is what two calculations, two processing you have to do it. First one is begin and end, you have to take it. In the beginning, what are the heading you want, you can write it the whatever I have shown the example, you can write it the same way. Next is the action till you have to move it till end of the file and store the informations into that one, including calculations, you can do it there. Otherwise, calculations do it in last only. First, take the informations and store it into the array. Then when you are printing directly, you can write it here. So like the same way, you can write it the calculations. So this one, So when you are printing, you print it the similar way calculations, 1, 2, 3, 4 fields, whatever you are taking, you print it. Next one is HRA, 15% means previous field into 15 plus another one. So print it separately. Anyway, that is the way of calculating the employee salary. So that is what the here is, let's calculate it. That's all. They have not asked us to compute the gross salary. Compute the gross salary is nothing but what? 10,000 plus HRA plus DA. So all three informations you have to calculate it and you have to display it. Otherwise, individual also you display it. If you have any doubt, you can ask me later. No problem. So that is what you have to do it, AWK. Now, any questions, you can ask me AWK. Our programming, if you have any doubts, please let me know. So today we have seen AWK syntax. Oh, what are all the commands it is working that I have shown directly through command line arguments. So some of the commands it is not working in command line that I have shown in the programming only. So whatever I have shown explained, that one you write it in the programming. So almost all commands have shown in one program. So only the calculations is left out, that you do it now. So calculations also one example I have shown there, how to write it also. The similar way you write it here and you can execute it in system. That is what you have to do it. So AWK, how it will be working, I have shown you. Syntax, I have told you. Data processing also, I have shown you. So that is what my task. So grep commands and advanced filters, how to do it, how to search it, how to processing the information. So that is what today's class. Ganesh sir?
Yes sir.
So shall I stop now? I have completed. What also is there?
Basic administration or
basic administration, I have told it. So we'll take some other day because time up now. So I have not shown any demo there, basic administration, how to create the users, how to maintain the server. So because of the less time. So we'll see that one later, sir. No problem. One more day I'll take and anyway, our students only, no? Okay. I'll show you that one.
Fine. I will stop the recording now.
Yes, sir. You can stop it. And Vasuki is there. If you